So for me, teaching is about personal connection and taking that time. The students know that you're taking that time. So I try to go to volleyball games. I try to go to other sporting events. I try to go to other things so that the students see me and that they actually know that I do care, where I'm taking time away from my own life to share in their experiences.
I think that even though Mr. Harris seems to himself or quiet or not the most happy, he really is excited to be here at school all the time, and kids are what makes him happy. And when they get to know him, they all really see that.
I take the time to stand outside my door and greet every student as they walk in. So for me, it's that personal connection.
I think that especially when you're a student, it's kind of hard to get in contact with your teachers because they have so many other things to do, like meetings and faculty and other students. So when you actually have a teacher who's gonna like respond like instantaneously, then it just feels really good, like someone's actually like paying attention to you.
So he really just wants to be that motivator if in case we don't have one, to really like push us and get us out of our comfort zone to be successful.
I think Brian's success with kids at risk is the way he treats them. He treats all his students the same, with care and passion, and he's just so concerned that everyone be successful no matter what level you're on. He doesn't treat you any different.
My goals for Brian was to be better than I was. You always want your kid to do better. So he attended Cal Poly and wanted to teach school and become a good teacher. I'd tell him that when you were a little kid, you used to walk on my feet, but now you're walking on my heart.
For me growing up, secondary education wasn't something that was important. Going to college wasn't seen as something that had to be done. My dad made a great living not going to college. So for me, being the first to graduate, it was a big deal to not only me, but to everyone in my family. When I was awarded County Teacher of the Year, it was a big deal just seeing any of my family here. And seeing my parents here was a big deal. My grandmother was here, but I think it showed that my dad was finally accepting of the job and the career choices that I've made. So about 5-6 years ago, me and my wife decided we were going to open up a comic book store. I think with comic books, the students relate to them. It's stories that they already know. So when I bring comics into the classroom, it allows them to see what I want to actually teach them in a new light. So when I want to teach Odysseus and the Odyssey and the hero's journey, we look at Star Wars. Or if I want to teach about revenge and the death of a father, I could talk about Hamlet or I could talk about Batman.
If Ms. Harris had a superpower, I think it would be the power to not read minds, but to put thoughts in other people's minds.
Well, if Brian had a superpower, I think it would be that his ability to read minds.
If Brian had a superpower, I think it would be super compassion for others.
If Mr. Harris had a superpower, I definitely think that it would be mind reading.
If Mr. Harris had a superpower, I think it would be the power to make superheroes, because he gives us a lot of confidence and makes us see who we really are and, you know, what we can actually accomplish.
But if I could have any superpower in the world, I think I'm happy where I'm at. I like to think I'm Batman. I don't have superpowers, but I have super gadgets, and I'm able to relate to the kids. And I have my utility belt of emotions that can be needed at one time or another to reach that student. When teaching a process essay, I've learned that students have a really hard time in explaining what a process essay is. So I came up with the idea. I remember when I was in fourth grade and we did how to make a peanut butter and jelly sandwich. So in my class, we do making waffles.
Okay, so why do you think I had you guys write about food? Why is food the topic of our biographical narrative? Food's good, everyone loves food.
And I showed them how to make waffles, and I related it to a personal experience with me when my dad used to make waffles. So I have them look at their own lives and a food that they like and why it means something to them. I've never even thought about what I would do without teaching. It's life, it's my life.